Hello, what's up guys? This is Sai Modeler with another Gunpla review. In this video, I will talk about the latest kit of Gundam Wing series released as Pibana exclusive in October 2020. This is the review of Master Grade 1100 Gundam Sandrock Endless Waltz with Armadillo unit from the Mobile Suit Gundam Wing Endless Waltz Glory of the Losers manga. Armadillo unit was a set of optional ejectable armor for Gundam Sandrock Endless Waltz, equipped with auxiliary boosters to improve the Gundam maneuverability. There are at least two versions of Armadillo units appeared in the manga, the one with a pair of Meganek shields and another version with Sandrock shields plus missile pods. The kit that we review today is the first version with Meganek shields. This kit comes with almost everything Master Grade Gundam Sandrock has, with several new stuffs. There are 7 new runners to make up the whole Armadillo unit, and a sheet of water slide decals to replace the stickers and dry transfer of the original Sandrock. About 90% of the assembly process was nearly identical with the old kit, where some changes were applied to the shoulders and backpack of the Sandrock. This is how the kit looks like without the Armadillo armor. While they look really similar, you may notice several differences between this kit and the original Gundam Sandrock. First, the shoulders have new connectors for attaching the Armadillo armor, which didn't exist on the original kit, where they're supposed to use this white part on the top of the shoulder. Another key difference is the backpack. Armadillo unit has an extension to connect torso and backpack, which makes it to be located further behind the body. The backpack also has boosters for each thruster, makes it much longer than the original. The Armadillo unit also comes with a pair of Meganek shield. The details on these shields are great, and you can see that there are 2 layers of armor for each shield, making them much thicker than an ordinary shield. There is a booster and an articulated flap on each side of the shield for extra gimmick. Attaching Armadillo armor is quite easy. First, attach the ejectable armor on the top of the shoulder. Then, attach the front armor to the underside of the shoulder armor. Do the same for both left and right side, and it is finished. And this is the Gundam Sandrock equipped with Armadillo unit. It looks so much bulkier than the original. Perhaps this is the bulkiest extension of all Gundam of the Operation Meteor. As mentioned before, this kit comes with similar accessories with the original Gundam Sandrock. There are shield, beam machine gun, 2 kinds of shuttle blade, 4 types of hand and few unused spare parts for the shield, backpack and inner frame. And like usual, there's also a figure of Katro Rabeba winner. With all extra armor, you may think that this kit lacks articulation. Well, it is partially true, more or less. The head could not fully rotate, and the same applies for the shoulder, where the movement is hindered by the backpack. There is narrow space for the arm between front and shoulder armor, which means you cannot freely move it while posing the kit. The Meganek shield could be moved back and forward, and you can also rotate it on its axis like this. The front armor connection uses ball joint, where it can be lifted upward up to 45 degrees and tilted slightly to the sides. Another thing to be noticed is the backpack connection, which is really easy to get loose. The reason for this is because it doesn't use polycap for the pack hole, which means there will be less friction to keep the parts together. You can fix this using nail polish or a tiny piece of tissue on the backpack connector to make the attachment stronger. Nevertheless, with the lack of articulation this kit has, you can still make cool poses with a bit of extra effort. You can also still use the Sandrock shield and cross crusher like the original Sandrock. finally, time for verdict. Like previous Master Great Gifts of Glory of the Loser series, I would say this is a nice update for the Masquerade Gundam Sunrock. The overall looks was nice, great details, and good gimmicks. Compared to the original Sunrock Endless Walls or Sunrock Custom, I personally prefer this version because it just emphasizes the Sunrock as a Gundam with the strongest armor among the other Gundams in the Wing series. Unfortunately though, the bulky armor mostly hinders the articulation of kit itself. So if you prefer a Master Grade kit with dynamic poses, then this kit is probably not for you. Otherwise, with some extra efforts, you can still make some nice poses with the kit, put it on an action base, and enjoy the badassery. Furthermore, this kit is a Piban exclusive, so the price might be jacked up if you buy it outside Japan. So again, whether you want to buy this kit or not, it is all your choice. And that's all for the review of Bibandai Master Grade Gundam Sunrock Endless Waltz with Armadillo Unit. If you have any comments or opinions, just give a comment below and don't forget to subscribe for more reviews of the latest release kits. Thanks so much for watching this video and see you next time in another Gunpla review.